So hey you guys, I hope you're still doing great, and alhamdulillah I'm doing so great. And we are continuing with this story. Where did we stop? Yeah, we stopped at I got married at 15 years old to this lovely, handsome, good-looking, energetic young man. It was love at first sight. Love at first sight, yeah. And me and my guy, we got married for 4 good years. So the marriage had its own ups and downs. We welcomed our baby on May 26, 2006. He's going to turn 14, inshallah, next month by the grace of God. And everything was so great between both of us, me and my hubby, until it reached a point whereby the mother-in-law and the sisters, they started coming in our relationship, and so many things happened that time. We had an agreement, me and my husband, like whenever I deliver the baby, I am going to go back to school. That one was so guaranteed. But whenever when their family came in to that story, it became like, no, if this lady gets married, she will leave you and she will get married to another man. And then so many things started happening. So many things started happening between the family and my husband. And what happened between me and my husband, we chose to keep it to ourselves between both of us. And we forget of what happened because we had our best good moment, and we never want to focus on the bad side of what happened between us, and we will never want our son to know what happened between us. So after 4 years of marriage, we decided we outgrew each other. And both of us, we were young. He was 20, I was 15, and I hadn't explored himself, he hadn't explored. So after 4 years of marriage, we outgrew each other and we led our own separate lives. And I went back to my mother's place, and class, the marriage was done. And what we did is that we remained good friends for the sake of our baby. The first year, it was not easy, though for me, like I had not really accepted, like, it's gone, like we are done and everything. But he is still the best thing that has ever happened to my life. And like, no matter what, no matter like we separated, no matter like we divorced, no matter like we are not staying with each other together, no matter like our relationship ended, he kept in touch for the sake of the baby. He would come, he would see the baby, he would do shopping for the baby. Like my son has never missed any birthday party, even since we left his father's place. He has always been there for my baby. So for me, I went back to my father's place, and I took up my broken pieces and I went back to school immediately the following year. It was not easy. First thing, my mom didn't support our marriage. She never ever supported my marriage. But however, when I delivered my baby, she came with my aunties and my, yeah, I mean, like women and my grandmother. They came to my home, and they brought gifts for my baby. Like, this is in our tradition. Like, when you get a baby, your mother comes with friends and they bring you stuff. Like, it's called like bringing Oshoro, like uji. Like, yeah, she came. But for the 4 years I stayed in my marriage, my mom had accepted, like, halas, it's okay, now she's married, I don't think she will, she's quitting. And I was so, I persevered a lot in my marriage because I wanted it to work. I really wanted my marriage to work. So, halas, after the marriage was done, I came back home and I went back to school. And my mother was still like, my mother still was not believing, like, I'm ready to go back to school. She was like, oh, like, nie. I pay school fees again, and then you leave the school fees and go back to your husband, because he still saw the bond between us, and then you go back to your husband, like, no, but my dad on the other side was so supportive, and he believed so much in me. And my grandfather also, my grandfather, may his soul rest in peace, he was my number one. My number one supporter, and was like, okay, you want to go back to school, only that, halas, yeah. So my dad did go to the nearest school that was near my home, and he asked for admission, and I was, halas, they said it's okay, she can come back to school. My father believed and still believes in me so much. This one, I know. He believes in, and I told him, yeah, are you ready? Yeah, I'm so ready. And I'm, yeah, I went back to school, and I went back to form two. From 2, from 3, and from 4, yeah. And I'm so grateful for those people that we were schooling with. And the headmistress at that time, Mrs. Muthike, she, alhamdulillah, I just thank God for her. And for the support from the school. Just 1 minute. So I had to rush because I had some food in the kitchen, and it was like it was burning. So the support that I got from the community, and that time I was a Christian. And the church itself, though it was not still easy, because people talked a lot, my family talked a lot, those people who you thought that they are so close to you and they need support and they will support you and stuff like that, they talked and trashed me. And I don't know, like, I was for that whole year of 2010, I was the laughing stock of the village, like, oh, how is Yeka Bwana, like, she can't get married, we knew she couldn't stay, we know her. Like, now she's back, she wants to go to school, like, how, let's wait and see, she can't study, like, and these things used to come to those people, like, you thought I would give you support, like, those people who are so close to you. But, Mungu ni nani, God never sleeps, I managed to finish high school. I forgot to tell you, when I got married, there is this friend of mine. She had just relocated to Nairobi to stay with her mom. I'm just saying this because it's honest from the heart. And when she heard that I was having a boyfriend, her, in high school, she wrote me a letter like this, and I'm like, I don't want you to be associated with you anymore. You are a disgrace to your family. You are a disgrace to me as your friend. I don't want ever to even hear anything about you. And this happened also to my family members. Most of them never wanted to be associated with me, like, hivyo, no one wanted to be associated with me. I remember these women in our village, who their daughters were, like, when I went back to school, we used to school together with their daughters, and they're like, where? Mimi, like, Starky, I don't want you to be with that lady. She not just, she's the one who gets married and comes back. Like, I don't want ever to see you with her. Yeah. People from my own home, people from my own village. And they warned their daughters, like, I don't want to ever see you again with Mariam. I don't want to hear, like, but God never sleeps. One thing I'm telling you, and I'm not lying, is that when I went back to school, I never used to perform like mashallah, but it's either one or twice a lady was ahead of me. It's either boys, it's 1, 2, 3 boys and then me, or 1, 2 me, but never ever, like, I had like 2 ladies ahead of me, once or twice. I thank God for everything. So I went back to school, and I did my KCSE in 2012. At this time I was studying and my son was still going to school. So in the morning we would wake up, I would get my son ready, he goes to school, I would get ready and go to school. In the evening we would come, I would prepare like supper, we would eat together. go help my son with his homework. I do my homework if I have, and then life continued like that until I did my KCSE in 2012. So that's another part of my story, and my story is long, and I will continue inshallah later. So stay tuned inshallah. Thank you so much for watching. It's Quarantine Stories, and please stay safe. If you have a chance to stay at home, please stay at home inshallah. Stay at home if it's possible. If there is anyone you can help at this quarantine time, even if it's 1 kg of unga, if it's 1 packet of sugar, or it's anything small that you can be able to help someone who is near you and might need help, inshallah, try to do that. So thank you so much for staying with me. Thank you so much for subscribing, and inshallah I'm going to continue with another story some other day. So much love, and God bless you inshallah. Ma salaam.